The COVID-19 pandemic has affected all aspects of life, and breast imaging is no exception. With vaccinations on the rise in many countries, there are a few important things to take into account. It is well established that vaccinations may cause axillary lymph node enlargement on the side of injection. This occurs frequently with the shingles vaccine, the flu shot or influenza vaccine can cause it, and now with the new COVID-19 mRNA vaccines. There's a few things we know the COVID-19 vaccine does not do. It does not cause breast cancer. It does not make it harder to interpret a mammogram. And lastly, it does not brainwash, track, make you a zombie, or any other conspiracy theory. But what the COVID-19 vaccine does do very commonly is cause unilateral axillary lymphadenopathy. The lymph nodes on the side of the injection get enlarged. This is usually asymptomatic, although a few patients do present with a lump underneath their arm. From what we can tell so far, it usually lasts 2 to 6 weeks after the injection. And oftentimes, it's not the inferior-most lymph nodes, but a lymph node or two higher up in the axilla. The first step that is required as a breast imager is to add questions to your intake form. Ask every patient, have you received the vaccine? What were the dates of the first and second dose? And on what side was the injection? Here is a patient's screening mammogram from 2019. Now, after receiving the COVID-19 vaccine, you can see unilateral left axillary lymphadenopathy. Here are several more examples of patients who received the COVID-19 vaccine in the weeks leading up to their mammogram. You can see mild axillary lymphadenopathy. The question with COVID-19 vaccines is if the story fits, is further imaging or intervention required? The first thing we can say with certainty is do not biopsy these enlarged axillary lymph nodes. If you are doing high-volume screening mammography and vaccinations are widespread in your area, you may find 20, 30, 40, or even 50 patients a day with enlarged lymph nodes. Some breast imagers are recommending short-term interval follow-up in 6 to 8 weeks after the second dose. This is a reasonable plan and something that is done frequently for other causes of reactive lymphadenopathy. The challenge with this strategy is that a large number of patients may need to come back for follow-up imaging. Another strategy that some breast imagers are recommending is to delay screening until 6 weeks after the second dose. In theory, this strategy makes sense. However, at MAMMOGUIDE, we always hesitate to tell patients to hold off on their important screening exams. And the last strategy that some practices are using is to simply continue with normal screening if the story checks out. If the patient had a vaccine in their left arm 2 weeks ago and now has mild left axillary lymphadenopathy, and the mammogram is totally normal, they may return for regular screening. If the patient has dense breast tissue, consideration for a screening breast ultrasound may be helpful to ensure that you're not missing an underlying malignancy. No matter which strategy you choose, make sure you're aware of the impact of COVID-19 vaccines on breast imaging. Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe to see more of our content or go to MAMMOGUIDE.COM to learn more about breast imaging.